Did you know that you can give people editing permissions inside of your software app? It's true, they can edit information in your app without even being logged into Airtable, all thanks to software's editing capabilities. Well, in this video, I am breaking all of this down. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and I own a company called Gap Consulting. We make it our mission to help you automate the bullshit. The biggest place for you to get massive improvements to your efficiencies is by mastering the basics of no-code automation. I put together a free training to help you do exactly that. So if that's of interest, check it out at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. I will include that link below this video. But without further ado, let's hop on into the heart of this. We're talking about using software.io to build a front-end portal, a front-end app for our users, and we want them to be able to edit information that lives back in Airtable. Furthermore, we also want to be able to change their permissions, change what they can edit, all based on giving them some sort of a role inside of the user interface. So how do we do all this? Well, first let's break down a simple Airtable structure and a simple software web app. So let's start with that Airtable backend. Here I have my table of users. Every time you build a software app, you're going to need a table of users. And at a minimum, it's going to include your name and email address for all of your users. But did you know you could also add a single select field that's going to function as a level of permissions? This is where we're going to assign a role to our different users that we want to have more advanced permissions inside of our software app. So this is pretty part and parcel, the name and email address, but we're going to use that single select field to assign permissions in a really versatile way. Next, let's also jump into our simple locations table here. This is just an example, but what I've built is the name of the location, an image, and a description. So I'm imagining an app where we're able to share this information, and based on who's logged in, they can either edit the name or edit the description. Maybe they can edit both, depending on what level of permissions they have inside of our app. So how do we get this to work? Let's head on into Softr and take a look at the front end that we'd build in our Softr app. Now I loaded this up with some simple default pages. I have here a list page where I'm listing out the different elements inside of our Softr app. We're looking at that locations table inside of Airtable. So we're looking at seeing the same three locations, Maui, Aruba, and the Bahamas. And of course we could add a lot more to this. And then if we click on one of these elements, we're gonna go a layer deeper. We're gonna get that detail breakdown where we see the image again, the location, and now we're also getting the description to that particular record as well. Remember for Aruba, it was blank, but if I back up and go into Maui, we do have a description for Maui that you can see right here. So let's imagine that on one level, we have users who we wanna have log into our software app, and we wanna give them the ability to update the description, but nothing more. How can we get this worked out? Well, first, let's head back on into Airtable and head over to our users table and first create a permission group for that particular user type. Let's imagine we call this description because this is exactly what we're going to allow this particular user role to edit. Now that we're all set here, we're gonna head back into Softr now that we have description as a type. Make sure you're now in the edit function of Softr. I was in preview mode previously. I'm gonna go to the user section on the left-hand side and I'm gonna sync this with Airtable. Now, if you've already got it all synced up, no problem. But for me, I'm doing this from scratch. So first I have to select my Airtable base. It was called Softr Edit Permissions. Here I found it from the list. What table does that information live in? That's my users table. And what's the email field? We built the three fields. Remember, by default, we have a name and an email, and we also have permission group. So I'm mapping to email here. You'll see that I also have the option to add my name field, a magic link field if you chose to include this, and an avatar field if you chose to include this. I think at a minimum you should stick with name and email, but get fancier if you want with the magic link and avatar as well. Now I need to make sure to save this up. I have now synced my software interface with Airtable. So let's go ahead and flip into our users one more time, and we're gonna actually add a user here inside of Softr. I'll add myself, Gareth. Put in my email address, generate a temporary password or a magic link if you'd like, and we'll go ahead and save and continue. Now in this case, I'm going to copy that magic link and I'll paste it in another window so that I can quickly and easily access this from my user. So now I'm logged in on this particular window as myself. I'm going to flip back now to edit mode so that I can keep doing a little bit of work on the back end, and then I'll flip into that user profile that I just created to see that my permissions are correct. Okay, so now we've got this person added into our database, and they're now a user inside of Sofdr. To confirm that, we'll also flip into Airtable, and we'll see that there is that new record created. So I can delete that first record that I accidentally created earlier. I have one user so far inside of this. If I want to give this particular user the ability to edit that description, first I want to add them to the description permission group. So I'll go ahead and make that selection here. Now let's head back into Sofdr, and on the left-hand side, we'll go down to our settings. Once we've chosen our settings, look for user group and permissions. And what I'm going to do is effectively create a group of users that have this level of permission called description, for lack of a better word. So let's go ahead into our user groups and click in here. You see right now I only have one group, it's logged in users. Well, I want to add a new user group, and we'll call this, not very creatively, description. So I have now my description user group. And I now get to set up the conditions that allow someone to enter this group. And as you might expect, it's pretty easy. I'm gonna say you have to meet this particular condition, add condition. The condition is the logged in user permission group, and that's because we have that field inside of Airtable, is, and then I have to match it. And be careful here because this is case sensitive. We have to make sure that we're matching this thing right here exactly as we wrote it inside of Airtable. So the user permission group is description. Let's go ahead and create that user group. So now we have this user group, and in this case, I'm actually assigned to that user group because I do have that level of permissions, but it doesn't really do anything yet. So now I need to go again into settings and go over to the user groups and permissions one more time. And here's where I get to edit permissions. Well, I can click on add edit permission, and again, I'll call this my description user group. And I can assign what these folks can do. I'm going to select the decision user group from the dropdown, and now I can add or take away permissions for this user group. So I will say, for example, in our case, Sofdr edit permissions is the base, and I want them to be able to what? Well, I want them to be able to edit the description field in the locations table. So pick the locations table from the dropdown, and now by default, it's set that they can both edit all fields and all records. Maybe I want them to only edit records assigned to them. Maybe I only want them, in our case, to only edit certain fields. That's what we're gonna do here, is actually toggle off all fields and instead say, you can only actually edit this description field. Now that we're good with this, let's create this permission. We're almost done here, but we have one more place we need to go, and that's actually inside of the app itself. So let's go ahead and pop open our pages here, and we'll go to the list details page. This is the page where we've clicked into a record on our list, and we're getting the details of that particular record. In this case, I'm looking at Maui. So let's go ahead and click into this block, and on the right-hand side, now this pops up. And on the far right of the panel here, I get the ability to change the edit permissions. So I go over to edit, and you see right here it says, again by default, only logged in users will be able to edit pages and blocks. Yes, of course, that makes sense, because we can only allow people with certain permissions to edit things. And in order to check for their level of permissions, they have to be logged in. So that's pretty self-explanatory. All I have to do is toggle, allow user to edit, and it's gonna ask me, well, who can edit? And of course, we know we built a special group for description user group. Let's go ahead and select them from the dropdown. Let's go ahead and publish now our changes, publish the updates. And now I'm gonna flip back to that other window where I'm actually a logged in user as myself. I will refresh the page, and once it's loaded, we'll see that yes, we are logged in as ourselves, which is demonstrated by my name up here. And I can see that I am signed in and I have the option to sign out. Well, let's go to that list page. And now from here, we're gonna select Maui, drill into Maui, and see if we can actually edit that description. And sure enough, as soon as I've hovered over this field, that little pencil icon pops up. By clicking on it, I get to now edit the information in this field. Let's take this out and say, this is an example. Save any edits that I made. Also notice that I could opt to do this in Markdown as well because this is a rich text field. I'll go ahead and save here. And a couple of things I want to point out. Almost immediately, that information is updated in Sofdr. But also, equally importantly, if I flip back into Airtable and I look at my locations table, I see that that text is also updated back here. So that's a really important feature that Sofdr is pulling live data from Airtable at the time that that page loaded. So far, we've been able to add one user group that can edit one field. But what if I want another user group? Let's call them admins, and I want admins to be able to edit everything in my app. How do we build this? Well, just follow the same steps that we just set up. So first, I'm going to go back to that users table, and I'm going to add a new permission type. Call it admin. Again, remember that this is a single select field, so I can only have one option chosen at a time. Let's head back now into Sofdr. Again, go down to settings, and we can establish another user group. And so by clicking in here, now I'll choose user groups again, and I will add a new group. This will be my admin group. And the users will match the following condition, and it's a simple condition. That role or permission group field is, and in our case, admin. Again, remember this is case sensitive, so match it verbatim to what you've put inside of Airtable. First, we create that group. Second, we go back to our user groups and permissions. We edit the permissions here, and we're going to add a new level of permissions for our new group, admin permissions. Again, select the user group, in this case, admin, and the permissions here are again going to be to the Sofdr edit permissions base. And maybe in this case, I want to allow them the ability to update all of the information in the locations table. So I won't get granular about what fields they can access. I'm saying you can edit everything in that table. Go ahead and create that permission. And of course, we know there's one more place for us to go. It's inside the actual page itself. And this is an important step because right now what we've done is created a group and given them the permission to edit data, but we need to tell Sofdr on what pages inside of our app are they allowed to edit data. So there's an important distinction there, and that's what makes this a three-step process. Let's now drill into our pages. Again, in our list details, choose that block here, and over here on the right-hand panel, make sure you're on edit, and now we can add a new user group. We need to tell Sofdr that the admin group is also allowed to edit things on this particular page. So let's go ahead and publish our changes now, and we will publish those updates. Now remember, I'm still logged in as myself, but in Airtable, we've now assigned me to the admin role. So if I go into my live version of the app and I refresh this page once again, now we see that when I'm inside of that page and I click on that pencil icon, and now we see I have a lot more options than just editing the description. I can edit the name, I can upload a new file, delete the existing file, and also bring in a new description or otherwise edit the description. Once I'm done, again, I click save, and those changes will be saved immediately. If we want to test that this is in fact still viable for two different user groups, all we have to do is flip back into Airtable and change the permission group for this particular user who we're testing. Now I'm back to just the description group. Flip one more time back into Sofdr, refresh that page so that we have a live version of the app. And here, when I go on to edit, I only get to edit the description, proving that I am now in that other description group. So just that quickly, Sofdr is able to recognize that I've changed my groups and therefore my permission level and the amount of data I'm allowed to edit inside of my app is different based on that permission. I know we went fast in this video, but I'm amazed that people are still unsure of how to grant editing permissions to users in Sofdr, so I hope you got a ton out of this. If you want to be sure to stay up to date on no-code news just like this, be sure to subscribe to this channel, and I will see you in the next video. As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly. And we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program. And for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.